Greetings and salutations of peace. You are now in tune on the one, the force itself. At this time, we call it the Holy Master Blaster Jamming. Itol Ivan decodes the June 2011 and 2010 Borino, Italy crop circle. Message from the God of Wisdom and the Lord of the Land, Enki. June 20, 2011, Borino, Italy crop circle, fully decoded by Itol Ivan I. Directly related to the one appeared in June 13, 2010, June 20, 2011 equals 12. Break it down, 3. This is a binary star. The pictogram depicts a binary star. So June 20, 2011 breaks down numerologically to the number 12, then break it on down. 1 plus 2 is 3. Torino, Italy, deciphered 3/17/2017. Binary involves the number 2. So here we see 2 stars. Here we also see a very simple multiplication problem of 7 times 7, which equals the number 49. We'll tell you how we get the 7 times 7. This number 49 takes us to Surah 53 of Holy Quran, Al-Najm, the star, verse 49 of Surah 53, and that he is the Lord of Siris. We also see an invisible star in the middle, not so pronounced. This is, so we see that the crop circle is a representation of the binary star system, Sirius. And we can clearly see by the ciphering of the researchers here, the binary coding that reveals that this is a message from the Anunnaki, the god Enki. The conclusion and heart of this message is that Enki and others, the Lord and his host, would reach Earth 7 years after that crop circle appeared. This would be their arrival here in the year 27, this current year. Note this was a ASC II code, or ASC II code, the binary language of computers used to break the code for the crop circle. When we know that the ASC2 or the ASC II is, we know what it is, we get an understanding that the sender knew it would be decoded because they sent it in a language that we could understand. So that stands for ASCII stands for American Standard Code for Information Exchange. It's a 7-bit character code where every single bit represents a unique character. Also note that the 2011 circle also says that the people who replied to the 1974 message is the same ones who sent the 2010 and the 2011 crop circle. And you could understand this by the open and closed dot system that they used. The American Standard Code for Information Exchange was the same code that was sent by the Anunnaki. And it was Enki, and Enki revealed his name. So when we take a look at the coding, we see that there are 7 points to the star. That's Sept, 7, that was the old ancient name for Sirius also. And there were 7 also dots. So we multiply 7 times 7, and I'll try to illustrate it that you see what it is. But basically, the understanding of this comes from the Akashic records. So when you read in the Akashic records, this information is there. So that's how you know that what has been revealed to you is correct. You are now in tune on the one, the force itself at this time. We call the Holy Master Blaster Jamming. So we see that the circle was partly interpreted, partly decoded, but no one else had deciphered that there was a message saying that they would arrive at a certain time, and no one said that it was from the Sirius constellation. And we'll try to bring that a little closer to you that you understand it. You are now in tune on the one, the force itself. At this time, we call it the Holy Master Blaster Jamming. I am your brother, the Rastafari. Basically, our information is derived from the light. The light is prevalent here. That's how they got here, on light. We look at the rays emanating from the star, which is the light. Then we note that we have 24 closed circles, or 64 shaded circles, 24 shaded circles, and 24 open circles in the 7 circles representing light rays emanating from the star system. It's a binary star with Sirius C hidden, or it's not so pronounced. So also, by reading the code, if you would, if you know how to read the ASCII, American Standard Code for Information Interchange, then the 7, it's a 7-bit character code. So that's a 7-bit character code, and the message from the crop circle, it also is also embedded with a 7-bit character code, which came in the form of rays, like sun rays emanating from the 7-point star. So we have 1, 2, about 3 levels of sevens emanating. So from the what's obvious, we say 7, the 7 rays, we multiply the 7 rays times the 7 star points, and we get 7 times 7, which is 49. So if we go to Surah 53, which is 8, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 8 is a symbol or the resonant number of Nibiru. So we know this information is coming from Nibiru, or the people of Nibiru. But this is a direct from Sirius, which is a binary star system, which is 2, with the number 2. Note binary, just meditate on this. Sirius is a binary that's called 2. And then the standard code is a binary code. So we call the computer codes binary codes. So we see that our DNA, which is basically comes from Sirius, is intertwined. So we're intertwined, or we have a destiny. Sirius is moving along with us. So all our information through the communication system, which is the sun. Sirius is our backup sun, so to speak. So Sirius is high behind our sun. So does Nibiru. So we have these 3 star systems in a row. So there's a communication system, etheric communication system, which we get the sun rays impregnates the ether, and we breathe the final particles of the air in, and we call this the Akashic records. So everything that's ever been spoken, everything that's ever been thought is on the Akashic records. So if you understood the number system, And if you're in tune on the one, the force itself, then you're able to read the Akashic records. You are now in tune on the one, the force itself. At this time, we call it the Holy Master Blaster Janet. And basically, in earth language, this is called inspiration. And the breathing in is inspiration. The breathing out is expiration, which is death. So the breathing in is life. And the breathing out is death. So it is said and is known by the mystics that God can be found between the two breaths, the breathing in and the breathing out. So that's why we encourage pranayama or deep breathing. If you do it long enough and meditate long enough, and meditation is the key. Meditation and medicine. Meditation was the first medicine, same root word. So we know that the process of meditation, when you sit straight, spine erect, automatically the ojas of the essence of the life force rises subtly up the spine in a double helix like a serpent, and goes through the seven chakras, cleaning the chakras and all of this. If you were studying my work, you will understand all that. I'm not going to get deeper into this. I just want to show you that crop circle has been totally decoded. I'm sure someone else can find more in it, because inspiration is really what opens your eye. It opens a door that you see deeper into it. But basically, the Anunnaki said that they are here right about now. So when this thing is going on down in the cold areas, and my pictures should understand it. It's not for me to make it so plain. It's a code. Anunnaki didn't say it plain. They sent a crop circle, so that's a code. So this is how we funk with you. Like George Clinton says, this is how, one of our major prophets said, this is how we funk with you, meaning this is the way we communicate with you. It's called jamming. Bob Marley said, bet you thought jamming was a thing of the past. Some of you did, but no, we're jamming now. We're jamming to the break of dawn. So we have reached the break of dawn. And it is written by our prophet Stevie Wonder, foremost, when you're moving in the positive, your destination is the brightest star. And the brightest star of the heavens is Sirius, the so-called Egyptian dog star. I hope you like jamming.